Flying cars, drones delivering pizzas, and a highway in the sky are scenes from science fiction, but they're also visions of our very real future.
Because we also moved this in and then that in.
At NASA Langley Research Center, NASA engineers are laying the foundation for safe autonomous flight in the national airspace through a project called Pathfinder. The goal of Pathfinder is to take separate urban traffic management projects and combine them into a single autonomous vehicle, then have that vehicle fly and communicate with other autonomous vehicles in the airspace.
Going back a couple years, we did a lot of on-vehicle testing, so we were testing things like Icarus, which is an autonomous sense and avoid, or maybe an autonomous flight management system for UASs, as well as Safe to Ditch, which is an autonomous safe landing or autonomous crash management system for UASs.
Combined, these systems will greatly decrease the risk of unmanned systems flying near manned aircraft, as well as safety risks for people below. To test this, researchers created incursions, where one drone flies too close to another, and then examining three different means of separation.
One is just manual, where the UTM operator has to get engaged and see that there's an incursion coming and then issue a command to the ownership vehicle to maneuver out of the way. Another form of air traffic separation we looked at in Pathfinder was called geofencing. And the third level was autonomous sense and avoid, and that engages another area of Icarus.
Icarus, or independent configurable architecture for reliable operations of unmanned systems, is a major piece to this autonomous flight.
You need to be able to make decisions to avoid other intruders in the airspace, stay clear from no-fly zones, or if you're inside a no-fly zone, the UAV should know how to get out of it, and to reroute itself around obstacles and no-fly areas. So some of these functionalities are essential to operate autonomously without human intervention. And so that's where Icarus comes in, and it provides those capabilities for UAVs.
As researchers conduct flight tests in the field, another piece of the Pathfinder puzzle is taking place in a separate location.
Copters beginning turn to the east.
Similar to an air traffic control tower on a standard runway, NASA Langley's Air Traffic Operations Lab is monitoring and making control decisions of active UAV flights.
These operators are observing their own vehicles, so their own small drone, and they're also observing vehicles that are operating near their vehicle. So the goal is to make sure that they maintain separation from all other vehicles.
Originally, these volunteer operators were going to be monitoring from the field. But after a unique communications link was created to connect the ATOL with the vehicles on the range, participants can now monitor the vehicles and traffic from afar.
This was sort of a first step for us. Ideally, in the future, we'd like to expand on this capability because it has a lot of potential. We have a lot of capabilities here in the ATOL for human factors research. And out at the certain range, they have a lot of capabilities for live flights. And by creating this link, we're really opening up the door to a lot of future research.
As Project Pathfinder nears completion, the team has moved from flights on the range to cross-center flights, taking off from the roof of a central building and then autonomously flying out to the range.
It's exhilarating, really, to watch a system that you worked on. You've developed the algorithms, and then to see it perform out there, it's really a joyful experience.
It was a great team. Everybody was really putting in a lot of effort to bring this all together. So that was really something I'll remember going forward from this project.
Meters to copter turns north.